We are not necessarily aware of it, but our soul lives a real process of evolution that spans many lives and can be divided into several cycles. There are five different cycles of soul evolution, all of which are important. Here are the five cycles of the evolution of the soul. 1. The baby soul. The baby soul is the most fearful of all, for it has never been in the material world before. It is both fascinated by life and afraid of material reality. The baby soul is afraid of this new world, but it also feels attracted and overcomes this fear by incarnating in a family nucleus in which it is offered enough privacy, in which reigns emotional security, where it feels supported, under no pressure. Here, the baby soul feels good. It saw the first incarnations a bit like in a dream, giving the impression of having its head in the clouds, of not being totally present. In the big family, the baby soul can overcome its fear, because it is always surrounded. It never finds itself alone in a room. It needs to be close to others because it feels deep anxiety and wants to feel reassured. Its greatest fear is to go out and be alone outside. The baby soul evolves slowly and little by little. This cycle includes several incarnations. Gradually, when it lets go and takes its first steps outward, it enters the phase of the child soul. 2. The child soul. The child soul is characterized by curiosity. It wants to be everywhere, to know everything, to see everything and not to miss anything. It is interested in everything that is going on around it, in all the subjects of conversation of others. Attending, observing and asking questions are its main characteristics. It is curious about everything there is to see and hear and incorporates all this information, like a sponge. The child soul is also able to perform simple tasks but flees demanding tasks. It is not able to think independently and draw its own conclusions from the information gathered. It takes each information at its nominal value. As the child soul reacts and leaves this cycle, it thus enters the phase of the young soul. 3. The young soul. The young soul rushes towards experience and is persuaded to be better than the others. It wants to show off its skills and be admired. It wants to be perfect and to engage in everything that it observed and listened to in the phase of the young soul. At the same time, it is very reckless, because no goal scares it, it wants to show what it can do to the whole world. The young soul has no inner certainty, is not ready to assume its responsibilities. If it fails somewhere, it will blame the others. It overcomes its insecurity with beautiful things and appearance. It will have a car, a house, and bright clothes. The young soul likes to show itself and wants to show the world how brilliant it is. Basically, the young soul lacks self-confidence, it lacks the experiences and values of an adult soul. At the end of this cycle, it can happen that it undergoes a deep trauma. Until now, it has had only external things as a point of reference, it has struggled to show itself and keep its mask. All of this suddenly escapes and it feels at the end of its skills. At this point, there is often a collapse. The young soul clearly sees its own fictional world, its own mask, begins to doubt itself and feels exhausted. It enters the phase of the adult soul. 4. The adult soul. Even the adult soul tends to experiment, but for this, it is important to understand them, to analyze them critically and to organize them internally. It no longer throws its eyes closed in things but carefully chooses the situations in which it wishes to find itself. The adult soul defines new priorities and new values, perceives its feelings and aspires to truth and authenticity. It places great importance on justice and drops its mask and outward appearance. Sometimes it is still afraid of not being accepted by others as it is. It needs to spend time alone to reflect, feel, understand and identify its own point of view. While the young soul transmits purely notional knowledge, the adult soul is situated in a new context, that of knowledge through experience. In the final phase of this cycle, it places little value on the titles, which were rather a centerpiece for the young soul. It enters the final phase, which is the old soul. 5. The old soul. Although the old soul is spiritual in nature, it does not always do so consciously. It consciously works with energies or clearly perceives its own inner voice, connects its consciousness to higher entities, thereby extending its vision of the world. It can develop its divinity and its potential in various ways. The old soul has clearly recognized its own path and follows it without any fear. It is as solid as a rock and exudes tranquility, peace, authority, and security even in a chaotic environment. There is a parallelism with a baby soul who dreams of entering life. It happens exactly the opposite to the old soul, it dreams of leaving life. The old soul has its own personal power and has great fortitude. It is characterized by great inner peace and authenticity. At the end of this cycle, it will return to its spiritual homeland forever. You should know that all the people who are currently on Earth have already lived several incarnations. No one is here for the first time. So you can have a period during which you strive for perfection, you participate in gossip and gossip, are very active professionally, go through crises and personal suffering and find solutions. Each of these phases is legitimate. Come back on your past incarnations and the evolutionary stages lived, not in detail, but rather by reliving the different cycles during this existence and by overcoming them.
If you want to uncover what has been encoded in your destiny when you were born, there's a free, personalized numerology report you can grab here.